Good morning, students. I hope you are doing fine. We had started doing the second chapter of Unit 1, The Adventure of the Mason. So the unit is based on adventure. So again, the chapter again also reflects the spirit of adventure, that what kind of adventure the Mason had in the story. So today we will be discussing about the question answer here. I hope you have understood, you have seen my previous videos and you have understood the story very well in detail. So let's begin with today's work. First of all, before starting up the question answers, you have to write the word meanings which are given at the end of the text here. All these word meanings you have to write in your notebook along with the part of speech which is given in the bracket. For example, Grenada, that's a noun. What part of speech is it? That's a noun, and the meaning is a city in Spain. So in the same way you have to write in your notebooks. Now let's start the first question. So the first question is, answer these questions with reference to context. Now said the stranger, you must help me to bring forth the bodies that are to be buried in this vault. Who said this and to whom? So now here you can see this line has been taken from here. So the stranger spoke these words to the mason. So the answer would be, the stranger spoke these words to the mason. Now the next question is, how did the person feel on hearing these words? Now see the next lines. The poor mason's hair rose on his head at these words. So that means this shows that he was terrified. So the answer is, the mason was terrified on hearing these words. Terrified means fearful, afraid, darna. Now the third question is, did the person really see dead bodies? So let's read the stanza again. So the poor mason's hair rose on his head at these words. However, he followed the stranger with trembling steps into the retired chamber of the mason, expecting to see some ghastly spectacle of death, but was relieved on seeing three or four portly jars standing in one corner. So he did not see any dead body. So the answer would be no, the mason did not see any dead body. So now next, the story begins, answer these questions. First part is, the story begins by stating that Mason was poor. Why do you think he was poor? Give reasons for your answers. The mason was poor because he spent all his earning and did not save for the uncertain future. Like we earn and we save also. So same way, just like your parents, they go out, they do a job, they bring money. It does not mean, but they do not spend the whole money. They save something for the future. So that's intelligence. That's the purpose. We should all do that. But the mason was not like that. So he was poor because he spent all his earnings and did not save for the uncertain poor future. Also, there was one more reason. He did not charge unnecessarily for his work, because he did not charge extra money. Unnecessary means extraordinary paise nahi mangta tha. He did not ask for like 50. If he had done 50 rupees work, he will ask only 50 rupees. He will not ask 100 rupees for that work. So he was a justified person. He was a just person. He was a very reasonable and honest person. So he did not charge unnecessarily. So that's why he was poor. Now next question, Why do you think the mason agreed to do the work when he was blindfolded on the way? So the stranger, let us see the text. That you shall be, but you must suffer yourself to be blindfolded. To this, the mason made no objection. That means he agreed to be blindfolded. Why did he agree? The question is, why did he agree? So the answer is, I think the mason needed money to support his family. Secondly, the stranger agreed to pay him accordingly. So when the stranger offered him the job, the mason took the job only on one condition: if the stranger paid him accordingly. Accordingly means according to his job, according to his work. Therefore, he agreed to do the job even when he was blindfolded. Also, so students, don't write this line. This has been repeated. Okay? Don't write this line, last line of the answer. The answer will only be cut this line. Cut this line. Okay? Write till blindfolded. Is that clear? Okay. Now look at the third question. How did the mason take advantage of his lucky chance? What lucky chance he got? That the vault, underground vault which he had made years ago, in that same house, that rich person brought the mason, he brought the mason to that house, and mason remembered, recognized that basin, the fountain basin, and he remembered that vault, and what was kept in that vault, the three or four big jars, portly jars full of money that were kept in that vault. So he remembered everything. He recollected everything in his mind. So he offered to stay in that house and repair that house till the rich man finds proper talent. And during his stay, he did not tell anything about the secret of underground vault. He took out that money, he took out those gold coins, and he became a rich man. So the answer would be, when the mason saw the dried basin of the fountain, just correct, do the correction here please, sorry, fountain, in the court of the mansion, he recollected the memories of building an underground vault under the fountain basin. He also remembered that they kept four portly jars full of money in that vault. So he offered to live in that house as a tenant until the rich man could not find a suitable tenant. Also, the mason offered to repair the house in portions. He did not reveal the secret of the underground vault to anyone and used the gold for his own family, and thus he became a rich man. In this way, the mason took advantage of his lucky chance. So these were the questions which were given in your book. I have written some extra questions. Write down these questions in your notebooks. The fourth question would be, what conditions did the mason put forward to the stranger before agreeing to be blindfolded? That means, on what condition did the mason agree to the condition of being blindfolded? What condition did the mason put forward? So the answer to this question is, the mason put the condition on that he should be paid accordingly, according to his work, before agreeing to be blindfolded, that he had to be paid accordingly. Now, next question. What was the job that the stranger wanted the mason to do? The stranger wanted the mason to build an underground vault under the dry basin of a fountain. Right? He wanted to build an underground vault. Now, sixth question, last question. What did the mason see in the court? Where was the court located? Now, answer to this question is, the mason saw a dried basin or fountain in the middle of the court. When the mason's blindfold was removed, he found himself standing in a court located in the interior part of the mansion. The court was dimly lit by a single lamp. This is what all he saw in that court. So that were the all the questions. I hope you have got the answers. Now you have to write down these questions in your notebook. Okay? Bye-bye. If you have any problem, call me, message me. Okay? Thank you. God bless you.